bit delayed because we were waiting for liquid, but they're here now and we are good to go. So, starting on cash, Optic versus Liquid, do you have a favourite?
Do I?
I'm not going to say do you have expectations, Dan, but I am going to say do you have a favourite? Do you favour a team?
It's difficult, isn't it? Well, obviously, this is the thing, right? So I just want to say Liquid. But again, these online matches prove to be a little bit random, right? Firstly. Secondly, at least the North American ones have been very, very turbulent. Secondly, Liquid, what's going on with the lineup? Thirdly, Mixwell's joined Optic, and he looks pretty good. But the expectation should surely just go straight out the window here. So we're going to see...
So basically, no expectation?
There's more or less no expectations. Okay. I think Liquid should win, but I have no idea.
That sounds like an expectation, though.
With the pistol going on. I'm going to see James. Please go ahead.
All right, so we're 3 versus 3. The bomb is going to get planted on default. Optic coming in for the retake, starting on the CT side here, as you can see. Bit of a HE coming into the site. There is another one. And we are good to go. One player on the site in the Liege, so... There are no nades for Kusa and Nightfully. They are forced to push in this situation. There's no defuse kit on these two CTs. They both line up and they get the frag. So Optic off to the good start on the first map of this best of three.
Yeah. Yeah, Mixwell will be getting the defuse. And it will be fun to see Mixwell on the AWP again in this series. We've seen snippets of him here and there through the small sample size of matches that we've had to cast of him since he has joined the lineup, replacing Shazam. And to be honest, he actually looks more promising from what I've seen.
Yeah, right? He does.
And that would explain why, you know, that reason amongst others, why they would have picked him up. He was definitely plucked from, you know, G-Bots, who, you know, he was a talent there, and he's now been pushed into a greater stage. So what a cool opportunity there for Mixwell. And it's going to be cool to see that story develop. I do wonder how his English is. I guess his English is probably pretty damn good.
Yeah, I mean, so far we've seen some good coordination from the players, so it doesn't seem like he has any problems. He's Spanish, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's actually quite rarer. I think Spanish are one of the countries, perhaps along with Italy, where the residents
France.
Speak a lot less English than otherwise. I think France, they speak more English.
Depends, I guess, where you are. In the countryside, I doubt you're going to hear any English.
Absolutely. But even in the big cities, English is a lot rarer in Spanish cities, that is. Kusa alone with the Glock here. A good damage gun, 2 kills, but it is round 3, so Optic will care not.
Fun fact, by the way.
Okay.
So, a long time ago, I was looking at English proficiency levels. Don't know, okay, so I'm not sure how they were measured, right? So take it with a grain of salt. But Italy was just behind Russia. And when I was living in Milan, the international city of an international capital, right, of Italy, the levels, it was incredibly, I couldn't communicate, it was impossible. I couldn't communicate in English. The only people who knew English were people who'd been to higher education. No one else knew English.
Yeah.
The old people, a lot of the youngsters didn't know English. And a lot of people that did know English, their English was very, very suspect, James. It was suspicious.
Suspicious English.
So I had to learn as much time as I could. And I failed, James. I can survive. But either way, we have a push here in the squeaky door. And it's going to be a lot of information here for Optic. And, you know, holding on to these SMGs as they are. And that's a lot of SMGs. It's really nice that they're taking risks with them. Because you have to level out the disadvantage somehow. And so you've got to take the risks. Kusta, ooh, this off angle is... Oh, it's savage, but Kusta was ready for that one. He's going to pick up the frag.
He's ready.
And now we will see that Liquid want to finish on the A-bomb site. 2 frags going towards them is definitely going to be nice. I'm not sure if Optic are really interested in a save, but with no frags thus far, I think that it might be the case, but they've got SMGs, so they're very throwaway. But I think the damage that they're capable of is becoming more limited as the site is taken and the post-plant positions are set up by the terrorist side. So it's a bit of an awkward situation here for Optic, I must say. Perhaps Mixwell can get some more damage done. We're going to see the flashes and someone coming in here as the T's are aware of the presence of the CTs. I don't think the CTs are under any illusion here that this retake is incredibly difficult. And wow, they're actually getting the frags at the flick from Mixwell, not connecting, and they're all lining up there, just holding the trigger and not pulling it as the teammate was in the way. Mixor does end up getting the frag onto Kister in the end. And he's one versus one against the Leech. Does he have time to do this?
Wow.
The frag comes in and he finds the bomb. This is remarkable. James, they had two SMGs and an AWP against five players post-plant with grenades, and they won the round.
That is a hero. What is that? That is a hero play.
What is this, James? What is that?
I was not expecting them to win that round then.
That is to me, the very question. I mean, what is going on? I don't understand. What is this?
I was wondering if they should save.
And I thought so as well. But then it's like they have two SMGs. Why would they save SMGs? You kind of want to throw them away, get some damage with them or something. And so it's like, well, I guess we go for it. Oh, we won the round.
We appear to have run the round then.
Oh, guys, we won the round.
Well, Liquid are going to pick up the Tech Nines. There is only Kevlar on Illige. Everybody else is pistol only. I do wonder if it's possible to really measure the usefulness of that one player with Kevlar and what else, you know, the other merits of the money there. But either way, we have Smokes into main, which will be a problem for Liquid. Again, Stanislaw holding a position we've seen done well by Taz recently. Going for the re-smoke in, but a bit too delayed on that. The T's will push, the T's will get sprayed down. Stanislaw with three. Up high looking for the last one. Adrenaline will be the man to find, and he will find him.
You know, James, I actually could see Optic being one of the teams that could beat Liquid because Liquid, right, again, there's been a lot of turmoil in the lineup, and we've seen, I think on some maps in the past that we've casted recently, there has been a little bit of a lack of structure, maybe, as they're starting, you know, they're trying to find their way, which is very, very, you know, very much fair enough. But I feel like Optic are one of the teams that could, you know, stand a test of the individual skill too, that Liquid bring, because Liquid can always fall back on that individual skill, because it is pretty damn good. As far as all the NA teams go, they are right up there on individual skill, and that's always a great fallback if your strategies aren't super polished or aren't going the ways that you would like them to go. But Nyxwell is about to see some action if he goes for a peek. Now, will he? Would be really awesome if there was a player highway to just throw a flash down for Nyxwell to peek with from that position. But looks like he is going to be alone, taking a bit of a defensive angle. And look how Liquid are just holding in mid there, going for the split. But the bomb is in mid. It would be very, very tough here for Liquid if Mixwell was to pick up both kills. There's the first one. Now the bomb is alone, but he has no idea that Nitro is by white box. Perhaps there is a suspicion, though, that having killed one player in mid and having not had the vision there, that Nitro or somebody could be there. And Nitro is going to get shot and back down to 6 HP. The call has been made now, and all of a sudden, Optic look fantastic. All these players rushing in here from Liquid, they have to look in so many directions right now. This is Optic's round. Maybe they'll win this almost flawlessly. Four players still alive, and they will remain such. That was impressive.
Yeah, I mean, when the first two plays went down, Liquid were in such a horrible position. Two plays squeaky, and the bomb in mid on its own. Like, that is beyond awkward, that.
What do you do?
That is beyond awkward.
What do?
Are they going to force it up here, the Liquid side? Indeed, they are. But what is their play? What is their execute going to be? Utility is limited. Reasonable, but limited. Optic, a big 5-0 to start with. That is just fantastic for them. Let's see how long they can hold it for. And let's see, is there a read on an A play here? They're going for the rudimentary boost, and it's going to come in quite timely fashion. Nitro moving in completely blind, and Stanislaw coming in with a two-man spray down. Finally gets traded by Kusa, but it's a 4v2. Naflies come in from the back as well. So if they try to plant the bomb, there should be no safe place to do so. And I don't think Liquid have any idea that there is a CT behind him, or Kusa's actually going for the peak now, but there are two there, not just one. Leaving Hiko alone versus three. Naflies heavily tagged. We've seen Hiko clutch on Cash before. Gonna try and secure the bomb plant for his teammate Daps. Will he realize that the plant is pretty close? He does. Going for a spray. Seeker down to 17, but he has secured the plant for his team. And that's all he will secure. 6-0 Optic.
Naf, that was an awesome play from Naf, I must say. Okay, because Naf had two decisions there. He could have tried to say, okay, I got a frag. I can get a second frag here if I push probably, and I've definitely done my job then. But in reality, what he did was he got the frag with the help of Stanislaw. Stanislaw picking up two there. And he dropped down, and instead of going aggressive, he took A main, right? And because there's T's on the site and his team is playing retake, just being inside A main is a lot of pressure on the T's. It makes it very, very difficult for them to safely do anything without that paranoia playing into effect. And so just by having his presence there, he's doing way more consistently than he would otherwise. Because if he does, let's say, try to take another battle, maybe he loses that, and then there's no advantage there. But what he does is always, by doing that, he always puts his team in a good position instead of maybe just getting the frag. And I like that method, you know, that thinking, that level of forethought there from Naf. That was good. And what a defense. Optic look head and shoulders above Liquid right now. They seem to be basically battering them in all the rounds that Liquid are setting up. If it's even in like a delayed mid take into a split, you know, any the A push that they just did, Optic seem really on top of things. So that's really interesting. This is why it's very cool for us that we get to see so much NACS in our league.
Yeah.
Because you know, we get to be exposed to some surprising things. And I'm surprised by these first six rounds by Optic.
Yeah, so 6-0 for Optic, and this is a time where we're seeing more T rounds being won on cash than previous, where you used to see dominating CT starts, or halves in rather. So 6-0 for Optic so far is great. Their economy is a little bit mixed. We have some players on about $3,000, some on $10,000, with the buy having happened already for Optic. So anybody who needed to buy anything has indeed done so. So what is the question for Liquid? Maybe they just start to slow things down. Maybe they feel like they're getting picked too early, so they'll just try to play the clock a bit more. We saw it in the first match today. It did work to a degree. You know, it allows the CTs to exhaust their grenades. However, if you wait too long, then, you know, if the bomb carrier gets taken down as you move into the site, the round can collapse. So it is a careful line to tread.
The annoying thing is that it's kind of the fact is that they haven't actually been able to do a lot of damage to the economy of Optic in some of these rounds. So they need to find. They do need to find some consistency, because they will be playing against repeated buys at this point. And maybe they're going to feel like some of these A pushes. Maybe they're going to feel like we got ourselves into the positions where we should be able to capitalize, but maybe we just miss a shot. So they might think, okay, we should be doing that again. I know this is something that a lot of there are a lot of in-game leaders out there that are very like Threat was like this, actually. You know, if he has a round that he thinks that it works, he'll look at it and then look at the positions that he got his players into. And if the position he got his players into is actually favorable, if you like, you can objectively look at it and say, get right should always win this battle, or should almost win this battle, always win this battle, then he's going to keep running it. Even if the result shows otherwise, he's going to try to trust the advantages he puts in his players into. So maybe, you know, there's still a lot to play with for Liquid. We have seen some great individual plays from Optic, so it's definitely far from over, but it really looks like a great showing here from Optic otherwise, and it's a fast mid take for Liquid.
So yeah, indeed, they've gone for the fast play, but they haven't managed to kill anybody because Optic have abandoned the mid area, and they've taken a main in response. But they still have three plays over towards A, while Liquid are looking good for a split into the B bomb site, taking Checkers and Toxic Area. It will be a problem for Optic to hold. Optic are currently using the AWP to try and hold down Highway, but indeed, Liquid are streaming into the B bomb site now. Nice drop into a flash by Daps, but how many players can he get? That's the bomb confirmed, but that would be obvious anyway.
Damn.
Two headshots for Daps, and almost taking down Elijah as well, but he will be saved by Adren. There's still a man advantage though for Optic, so despite having only two people over towards the bomb site, they've done a great job in slowing things down and getting more frags.
Yeah, catching Mixwell off guard there. Mixwell was kind of pulling out Nino, expecting the aggression. He pays for it with his life. Hiko now alone in a 1v2, and Hiko cannot get it done. It really feels like Optic are firing on all cylinders. Every single player from Optic, when they are put to the test, they are delivering something there. Daps did really have an amazing defense, because the kills that Daps got stop the progress onto the site being resulting in the bomb plant, basically, and also created some space, some time for his teammates to actually rotate, and then create a situation of pressure where the T's then couldn't plant the bomb, because if they did, the CTs would just overwhelm them instantly. And so 7-0 is the scoreline, and this is a shocker right now for me, just to see how well Optic are dealing with all these rounds, hitting the shots, putting themselves in good positions. But how long can they remain so clutch? I wonder, will Liquid's strategy see them through this best of three, or will this be the story? And we'll see a plant attempt here with the buy from Liquid's Tech-9s, the armors, a bit of a quasi.
Boom.
Oh, the quasi, the deagle. That is beautiful right there from Nitro. That is how you enter a bomb site with a 1D, James.
Yeah, and I have mentioned that, so these Molotovs towards the plant spot can often be inconsistent from the CTs, and that one hits the roof and goes nowhere. So the plant does come in for the T's four of the five players have full armor as well. So how are Optic going to respond? They didn't have any damaging nades left, just the flashbangs and the smokes. Going to split the defensive towards quad, but that bomb is ticking. Mixwell coming in now, but the numbers are getting cut down here. This is looking good for Liquid to try and take this. Down to two versus two, but the bomb is surely too far ticked. Mixwell needs to go in for the hero defuse. Does he have enough time? It's going to be a close one, Dan. And I think he's got it. Oh, that is a close one indeed. 8-0, though. Optic continue the routes. They continue the stomp.
Yeah, could be gutted there, Liquid. Probably felt like they had that one at the end. And we'll see.
Mike?
I'm pretty good at this, James. Yeah, going to be feeling gutted, I think, after that one. I'm sure Liquid felt like they had it. But Optic, they're going to be in a situation where they're just going to be able to dip into that lovely deep pool of cash. They could be swimming around in all the coins at the moment, fill a swimming pool with it, and then swim around, although it probably would not be comfortable. We have Optic, that's playing quite close here, so mixing up the setup a little bit, and Liquid are looking to go for the B set piece. We have the nades being set up now by the Liquid side. How well will Daps respond to this? And of course, he does have some support as well in Nafly, but in checkers. So this is going to be very, very cool to see how the defense is. And they got a third player in Vence too. So actually, the setup here from Optic is really, really good. Will they make the frags here? They're lining up here. Lots of damage done to the T's. However, need to get the bomb planted right now. Ooh. Oh, and it's lineups after lineups. But still, two versus two. Somehow Liquid fragging well, quite well back, despite being in unfavorable situations. And Rush's position is surely going to get him a frag. But no Hiko checking the position of Rush. And that's going to be Mixwell dead as well. So finally, Liquid claim a round. It was somewhat costly, losing three players, but Optic, you know, they're going to be able to throw one more buy in there. A full buy as well. Let's see if they can reset Team Liquid to rub salt into the wound. Or will Optic start to lose grip? Will Liquid start to find some consistency and string some rounds together? If they don't, they are in a lot of trouble, to be honest. They cannot afford to lose this round. That is going to be so devastating. You got to think that Optic would be more than capable of getting five rounds on their T side.
I was kind of pulling for the clean sheet then.
Oh, you wanted to see
after
the 16-0?
After the eight rounds, I just wanted to see how far they could go without losing a single round.
It's not like when you see it.
They finally have. So again, Optic are going to leave Liquid to their own devices in the mid area, putting three over towards the A bomb site. Now Liquid going for a slower play. Obviously, this is a very crucial round for the T's. With only one round on the board, if they were to get reset in this position, that would be a catastrophe. Neither team has much money in the bank now, after some expensive rounds for Optic and obviously losing that one, finally. You can see Mixwell only 1,400 here. So Optic not going to just rest on their lead, going for an aggressive push here. And I think Mixwell will be left over towards A main. But what will Optic do with this information? They do not have eyes towards A main. Sorry, Mixwell's pushing Squeaky, in fact. Did he just see that player? I think he did, because there was an instant rotation from two players towards the B bomb site. But are they going to get there fast enough? It looks like that's a very timely smoke indeed from Rush, actually. And Mixwell takes down Hiko in the back. Molotov's in as well. Daps is going to kill Nitro with the Molly. Rush's position is still secure for Molotov, but Koops is holding at the angle and taking down. Bit of a shot through the smoke there. Three versus three. All the players for the T's on the site now, and Mixwell is still making his way to the site as he gets planted. Oh, well, gonna have to change position now thanks to that Molotov.
Yeah, very interesting stuff here from this 3-on-3 situation. I really don't know who's gonna take this. Definitely the T's have an advantage with the positions that they have. And so there's no nades left on the TT side now, so they got to go in dry, no flashes for them. Nice tag though onto Elise, down to 7 points of health. That could be a very important factor. Let's see if the CTs can do it now. They have a lot of time. Nice step and a flick from Elige. Easily dispatching Stanislaw. It gets taken down from the back though. Naf is going to find the one versus one. Mixwell in a situation he just is not confident in. I don't blame him. We'll retreat with the AWP. And the money for Optic is such that he couldn't really afford to go for this. And so it'd be the second loss here. And you can see the money. It's not horrendous here for Optic. And with the AWP, they can buy some pistols and maybe some Kevlars behind it. And I mean, Stanislaw could drop some pistols. I think that's actually exactly what he's doing. Dropping some P250s, I think two in fact. And buying CZ armor himself. So Buying down to the kind of money that the rest of his team has. So in the next round, they'll actually be able to afford AWPs again and have a really strong buy. But this round, is it already looks like it could be quite scary if Mixwell finds himself in the right spot. And Mixwell has been playing very passively, I got to say, on with the AWP. They definitely don't seem to feature him, as you would see maybe Senphis, for example, on TSM.
Yeah, well, I guess they're a more organized team, so the carry is less required by the man operating the AWP. Still early days, though, but it seems to be going well for OpSec so far. Daps gets taken down. What can Mixwell do? How will they use Mixwell in this particular round? Will they try to... well, he's moving away from the A site, actually, while the rest of his team are there. He will be holding a passive angle towards B, I think. Ultimately, the plan will be to try and hold on to the AWP. Liquid taking a slow approach to the A site. And OpSec just waiting to receive them. Bit of a peek coming in. Instant punish from Kustar. And another one onto Nafly as well, making this anti-eco much easier for Liquid.
Yep, but it looks like it's going to be interesting, actually, because in a way it's going to be nice that Mixwell's not committed to try to save, or rather to try to go in and go for a retake and lose his AWP. He might get some damage in here because they're trying to hunt them down. It's going to be quite... I mean, it would actually be really, really big if Mixwell actually defended and got those two kills, for example, just from the economy standpoint. But again, as I said, OpSec are going to have a big buy in their account anyway, so I think they care too much what happens here. And look at the fervor here from Liquid. They're really pressing hard to get these kills. And interestingly, it's going to actually be just only one or two there from Sanasol in the end, and now we get the buy. So not really going to matter all too much, those the end around situation. And I'm curious now if Liquid will be able to continue this momentum. I mean, OpSec, they look so amazing. But as we said, there were some of those clutch situations where OpSec were just able to deliver. Perhaps, perhaps again, Liquid weren't not necessarily doing anything wrong, putting their players in the right positions. It was just a matter of when, OpSec would stop being godlike, more or less. And that can often be the case. Now, it's going to be a slow start to this round for Liquid.
Indeed, and this time OpSec are taking more presence in the mid area, so changing things up. Now they've started to lose some rounds. I respect that. I like it. It's good. Eco going for some harassment towards Squeaky Door, but nobody's holding said angle. So not much information from either team on how their opponent is playing. Although we do have a force out of the vents from the CTs, but Kustar will fall to his opposite number. Mixwell will harass anybody trying to pick up the AWP, and indeed he will receive harassment trying to exit the checker's position, but it is a man advantage here for OpSec. Liquid moving towards a main at the moment, and I think they have a player in mid, they did. Adren was there, but he is now history, courtesy of Nafly.
Yeah, here comes the push there. And so we'll see all that he's facing, and they're lining up for Daps. He'll get a triple on the spray down. In fact, Elise helping him out, taking down Nitro again. Nice. That lineup is just... We're seeing a lot of lineups, James. They are lining up.
I think there was a team kill there. I think the first frag was kill. Yeah.
Yeah, it was Elise.
Ah, I see. Kill. Yes.
As I said, James.
Yes, you did.
I used my words to indicate this.
Words with friends.
And now 9-3 is the score here for OpSec. One more round and they force, probably a force here from Liquid. I doubt Liquid are going to try to do a double save. I think they'd rather just go for two forces. But we'll see if they get it in Mixwell. The 1-2, not the 3, but Daps is in there onto Adren anyway. And all of a sudden, all the heads have been cut off the Hydra. There's just really one prong that's really concerning here for Liquid, rather for OpSec, and they're able to disincentivize Nitro from trying to push forwards there, suppressing fire onto the vents, and Nitro has to find another way around. Kustar trying to make something happen towards A, and it does look to be that Nitro will join him for that. But will it be in vain here? Only one player. They have picked picked a good bomb site, I would say. It's going to be harder, I think, for Nafly than it will be for Daps on the B bomb site. Let's see if they are able to make the entry here. Naf in a good position, though. Predictable, but good. The tension, they're building, they're playing this so slow, James. They're building the tension. The tension is building. It is palpable. Oh, There you go. The entry is made. Now that makes things interesting. Now Liquid have an advantage. Bomb being planted now. Ooh, the fire is a little bit too short, and that happens very often, actually.
Well, I think it was good for default, but not for the secondary option, the optimal plant for the T side. Kusa getting smoked off the angle, it seems, leaving Nitro alone. That is a good Molotov and a nice flashbang coming in, but it's not going to do the job, and down Nitro goes. Kusa will trade, though, but Kusa can't do more than that. Rush gets the frag. 10-3 it will be. Optic with a monster CT half so far.
Kind of crazy not to see them playing the crossfires there, especially with the player, the plant for A main, but...
The smoke, there was a smoke there.
Oh, the smoke there,
smoked
right.
Off afterwards, yeah.
I apologize for my lack of awareness. I am a horrible human being.
I hope I am forgiven. I'm still with you.
I hope I am forgiven. So 10-3. And Optic, they start to return to their dominance. They are looking really good here. They could very well get the 12-3. I mean, if you look at this the situation for Liquid, as I said, you know, going for, instead of just going for one save after losing a round and then a bye, they're doing two forces, which I think is makes the most sense by far. And they would agree they can get a set piece in here with all the nades that they're able to stockpile. But will the nades do much? We've got the A retake playing planned out here for Optic. That's actually really smart, playing A retake in a situation like this. Because the Tech-9s will overwhelm you. With rifles, it can go wrong in a number of ways.
Nice.
Oh, boom.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
The Molotov coming in from Sanistora as well. And indeed, that plot, that actually spreads to the corner as well, it looks like.
Yeah.
And the plant will be delayed. You can see the CTs almost moving around the smoke, but they will indeed allow the Ts to plant the bomb. But that Molotov did allow the CTs to get closer to the site, which means they've got more time to go for the retake. They can be more meticulous and a bit more patient. Nitro is on the high ground with the AK. He's going to be crucial for his team because he's the only man with a rifle in this round. And here come the CTs.
Yeah, I wonder if this will come down to the fact that Incendiary caught them 7 extra seconds. Here they go, though, combining for the retake. And these frags are coming so easily now for the Optic side. Just going all the way around every single nook and cranny. Kusa trying to get the GG Molotov in there. Oh, it's going to be burning them. Oh, but they have this, there's a smoke down there as well. That is very, very good there. It would have saved themselves with the handy smoke. And it's a three-player survival, so you got to love Optic's cognizance there to say, you know what, this round we are expecting a force buy. We're expecting maybe a fast play on A. We don't want to get caught off guard on Tech-9s. We're going to play A retake. And the way that the retake panned out, you could see that everything was planned. There was forethought here. They weren't purely reactive. This is something they have thought about in practice. And beautiful. I really like that. I am impressed again.
Ooh, we have a one-tap coming in from Rush. The one-tap onto Nitro. Nafly having just a brief spray. Don't want to stay there for too long. Those tracers could have him punished. And no flash for Rush, actually, but the players are on the site quickly. Rush taking down a Dread. Oh, Kusa getting pinned to the wall by Mixwell. Another shot for him down onto a lead, leaving Hiko alone, and he will get finished off. Ravaged. 12-3. Solid performance there. Mixwell, 20 frags.
No assist, James. He shoots to kill.
He does indeed.
Or he just kills everyone or not.
Do you wonder that's also possible. If Shazam is watching. He's like, yeah. Can't really argue with this.
Shazam.
Solid from Optic.
He's in Europe right now. He should be asleep, James.
Looking good. I hope for his sake that he's asleep then.
Yeah.
Because this is strong. This is good. This is fast. Pistol time, though. Who will win?
Who? We'll win the pistol.
Who will defeat the Roshan?
He will defeat the Roshan.
I don't even know what game that's from. Is that from
Dota?
League of...
No. Dota.
Is it from Dota?
Yes. I don't remember the other things that
the first
that
Roshan, right?
Says, what?
Who, and then it's the nice round. Who will defeat the first Roshan?
Oh, right.
Because it respawns, right?
Yeah, it respawns.
Who will win the first night?
For like every 10 minutes or something. I can't remember. Can't remember. It's been a long time since I played Dota.
No, Roshan's in CS, mate.
No, but
the Glock looks like it has a vent in the back of it.
It would be amazing. What are you doing, James?
I'm waiting for the madness to begin, man.
You're a problem, James. You are deeply,
I'm just looking
down. You're deeply sick, James.
Just looking at skins.
deeply sick.
12-3. Optic. Well, Liquid with it all to do. Liquid with aggression. Three-man push towards B. They're going for the info. And Kusa taken down Mixwell. The bomb is down on the floor in mid. That's information for the Liquid side. This is an odd one. It is an odd one. There is a player on short for Optic, but Kusta could peek and get the kill here. He has the range advantage. I don't think the Glock will go for the one tap from this position. Stanislaw getting tagged now. He's just standing there in isolation. What is the plan here from Optic? I don't know what they were going for.
Maybe he wanted to backstab, but only having two players on the push, that is troublesome. However, James, it's all okay. But you know why? I'll tell you why. Because it's time for a force buy.
I mean, Liquid pretty much always play a retake pistol. So I guess...
So do they do the Volov?
I guess...
That's what you're going for, isn't it, James? You want
them to run through the door. I'm just trying to figure out what the plan was in that round with the player on short. Perhaps it's an off angle to get people rotating to mid, to the vent, or I don't know. I don't know. Either way, it didn't work out, and Liquid have a great opportunity to get themselves back into this match. They are 8 rounds down at the moment, and indeed, the squeaky door will be the play. Adren holding a bit of an off angle, and he will come in to close the door with a bit of a spray. Not sure if it was opened again. No, not yet. Well, it's actually no one down for either side yet. Stanislaw and Mixwell are slightly tagged. Kustar just going for the passive peek. Pop flash coming in, choosing not to retreat just yet. And now he will start to back off. So he go under the vent. Great angle for him. MP7 coming in, finally traded over. The P90, the Justice Cannon, showing the lore to all these Optic players. Now Daps is coming into his judgment. And one kill. Could have been two, actually. Kusta flying in from the heavens. Close to Tech 9. But there we go. Liquid survived the test. And now Optic move to the Eco.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, what do you... I hate these rounds. This is like... What do we do? In a round like this, there is nothing you can do, James. You must give in. Give in to the greater power. That is the P90.
Yeah. Well, again, let's see, two pistols. They've got a flash onto that, in fairness. And that flash can get them close enough to do some damage towards A, so I don't mind this.
Indeed,
Daps has the usual angle, but Adren with the P90, he's expecting the same play, and he is coming in for the flank. The glory is brief. It's very brief indeed. It's brief glory, Dan. Adren with the brief glory.
Okay. What does it mean? What does it mean?
His glory was
brief.
I feel
like every time we cast, we have...
Brief glory?
Like, we have like epistemological issues, like we're discussing, you know, what is and what is not. What is knowledge, James? What is knowledge? What is known? And then we have moments like that. It's pure elation at the...
joy, Dan. Joy.
The moments of pure joy, such as the P90 spray downs. Does it life get better than that?
Faze just tweeted that. And he says, Mixwell came to North America and is probably the best North American player instantly.
That's hilarious.
Optic found
a
gem.
That's a bit.
Dude bit. Communicates, has a sick AWP, and plays smart as duck. As a G2A, I go.
Yeah. That is quite funny. Shouldn't you be casting, James, instead of reading Dave's Twitter? Although, we could commentate his Twitter if you want.
You are correct, Dan. That is a very good point. 3-3 now. Optic still in control of the bomb. Two players for Liquid over towards A, and we have a lone soldier in Hiko. Reliable hands towards B. And the frag comes in. Oh, Kusta takes on the bomb, but is there going to be a trade? There's no trade just yet. The Tech Knight comes in, and he's got the bomb. Kusta's got the bomb. Stanislaw coming in from the back. But Kusta, he needs to shoulder peek him and try and avoid getting AWPs here. And indeed, he's managed to do so. Hiko out of position as well. And he maybe... Oh, no, he's not going to spot the cross, actually. The plant coming in. Kusta going towards Squeaky. Is the door open? Is the door open, Stanislaw? Tell us. Tell us, Stanislaw. The door is closed.
It's about to be open, though. Like I said, when does he dare? It is a hard decision. But the door must be opened. And the frags must be made. And Kusta is good. To be honest, Tech9 is probably decent for that. Considering that you're just gonna... You wanna run and gun.
Yep.
It's Team Liquid those 7 rounds and Optic with 12. Optic starting to lose grip of their advantages. We'll have to see the mix world that was described by Daze there. Sooner rather than later, but not now because Optic need to save once again. We'll see maybe a Quasi and indeed the Quasi is seen. Mixwell is just going to get the Tech Knight and the armor. Wants to keep his economy good enough for that the AWP, not the AK-47, but definitely the AWP. And we shall have the quick pop flash play in from Nitro, just flashing in there. I'm not sure about that flash, but it was a flash, and there was another one from his teammate. So they do get the angles onto the A-main. Thing is, though, those flashes won't actually really flash the guy. It does like an AWP peeking very, very far away. He won't really get flashed there.
Yeah, I wonder about the timing as well, but I'll get to that in a second. We'll see if Kusta can hold here. He's doing really well with the Tech 9, actually. The bomb is down again. Kusta is the bomb stealer here for Liquid. See if it can be retrieved. Dinosaur coming in. Nice jumping peek, and he will take down Nitro. So we're down to 2v1, in fact, and the bomb's taken away from Highway. Adren trying to rush in, trying to take it away. Sandstorm moving to under the boost position. Smoke going down, and he will try to cross, but he will not be able to do so. So Adren versus Daps. Adren with three angles to look at, although Highway is unlikely. But will he see Daps coming in from the back? Ooh, Daps actually choosing to come towards car. This is super interesting, as they're both going to kind of come to the same place at the same time. The timing there was quite interesting, and Adren saves the round for his team. Liquids continue to climb back towards the score of Optic. Four rounds away now.
That was pretty scary. That was pretty scary. And when I made the point about the flash there, it was like a general point instead of saying in that round specifically due to the fact that they were on Tech 9, James, and that was known as well, of course.
But true. Well, but if I don't know about the spawn timings for that particular situation, but if a team managed to get behind the box, he has all day to see that flashbang come in, crouch, and then go in for the attack.
That first one indeed. Maybe the idea of the first one is to make the guy think that he's got it, because then there was a second one to follow, which was actually a pop flash.
The good thing about the damage that Optic did in the previous round is that Liquid basically have no money in the hole. So if Optic are to win a round, then there is a very good chance that that round will enable them. It'll at least give them the opportunity to take the entire map. Now, Kusta's playing an off angle here. Up, I know PTR likes to play this as well. Obviously, if people are going for a pre-fire of quads, they are almost never going for a pre-fire on top of the barrels there. So Kusta is very likely to indeed get the kill.
And if they are, James, well,
more power to them.
What do you say about that?
Yeah.
I'm going to pre-fire the top of the barrels.
Are we seeing a short smoke here? I see a smoke being lined up somewhere. We've got the Molotov mist altogether. That is really bad. Adrenaline gets taken down, but are they going to check the event properly? No, Rush is going to get taken down. Was that a Molotov miss from the boost itself? I mean, Elijah's got two kills now. You can't be missing basic grenades like that.
Elijah might not be long for this world, though. He's got a T on coming, but there are players. Ooh, can't pick it up. He can't get the kill on the headshot. That's really problematic now because assistance has arrived. Elijah now alert to that position, and Sandstorm, he's still there. I mean, they're going to call for this, and Mixwell's going to have to do a lot of damage here. Oh, first kill made. Good stuff there from Mixwell, showing his skills. But what else can be done? Mixwell going for the shot. He's going to miss it, and that is the bomb gone. And there is a problem here for Sandstorm. He needs to survive, but he can't. Oh, no. The money for Sandstorm is going to be appalling. He can afford a P250 and a decoy. A P250 and a decoy. That's what you get, friends. He gets a smoke and a flash, a decoy.
That's
a smoke
good.
And a decoy.
That's good. That's good. Yeah. I respect that. The smoke is far more important.
Yeah. Yeah, he can be dropped to P250.
But nobody will, of course.
No one's going to drop him.
Rush relief with $350 and Stanislaw will be on the Glock to get wrecked.
Is he actually on $350?
In the words... Oh, actually, I can't say the words of the anchor. Yeah. It's longer than get wrecked. Two-man spray down is possible here. Again, Mixwell behind the box. This is what we spoke about. And the two-man spray down comes in. The garden hose down. 3v3.
Yeah. It's definitely a troublesome time here. As Kusta would like some assistance, perhaps. But he will get none just yet. However, the smoke is going to allow him a very nice kill. That flick just a bit too much. As we'll get the frags coming in. Mixwell with another one. There is the 3K for him. He is very low on health here. He wants that AWP. Oh, yes. His bread and butter. And he's got plenty of time right now. Hiko, though, he's done this before. He did this against four players in that semi-final versus Luminosity. Mixwell, though, this guy is sneaky.
He's fast.
What a play. Almost looking to just completely circumvent Hiko entirely anyway, with all the time he had left to play with. Connects the shot, saves the round there with a 4K for Optic. And I am starting to become a bit of a fan of this guy from all the stuff that I've seen. Also, Dave thinks he's good.
Yeah. Well, I mean, Simple said half the reason he left North America was because he was becoming a worse player there. So you do wonder if Mixwell will feel the same long term. But so far, so good. He is putting in great work for his team, and Optic look considerably stronger.
Yeah.
Hiko's on the Nova now. Desperate times for Team Liquid, and they're getting taken down from the back, Dan. No eyes on mid whatsoever, and it is a wrecking ball which Optic are swinging on. Everyone going down. Elige is alone with a 5-7 versus 4 full health players, Dan. I don't fancy his chances.
The cool thing with Mixwell is that it's like, can you imagine being Optic where they're like, they find this guy, and like, no one knows about this guy, but we do. And they pick him up and they start wrecking people, and like, yeah. We've got this guy who's considerably bolstered our ability to play, because we've got an AWP that's stable that can rifle. That, well, as Ace said, I, this is what I asked previously, right? Because I didn't know about the level of the communication. But, you know, I don't know what Dave bases it off, but I'm sure he wouldn't say it if there wasn't a reason to say it. And he says the Mixwell good communication, therefore I imagine his English is decent.
Well, you can see it in the play. I mean, in the last match we watched of theirs, he had good coordination with other teammates to do well-timed things, double peaks, flashes and the like. So it tells you that the communication is there.
So it's, it's really interesting to see what is going on there with Mr. Mixwell. And to be honest, that save with the AK and very low health and then picking up the AWP, I love how he died for the AWP. There's a lot of players that probably wouldn't have done that, even AWPers maybe, but he wanted that. He's like, here we go, give me that AWP for the 1v1 versus Hiko. Makes sense because he has such low health too. But, the push coming in from Liquid here is actually going to be good initially, but the trade's coming back in the way in the favor of Optic. Hiko doing the smart thing, letting, at that point, just cutting his losses and being like, okay, guys, you guys died so that I can frag.
They've abandoned Stanislaw, though, and he's got 2 HP and the bomb, so I believe they want to retrieve that. And now he will be left to hold the angle, but somebody needs to collect that bomb. It's in a safer place for now, so.
The greatest skin I ever opened, James, was a Man at War stat track, minimal wear. From a case. I have not opened that many cases. I use it.
I'm not going to talk about skins, Dan.
To this day. I know, because you are a fiend. And I'll start you fiending again on skins.
Yes. So Optic 2 rounds away from the first map here. And Liquid are a man down. Optic waiting extremely patiently, actually. Ooh, Rush, what is he doing? He's got the bomb. Okay, the team appear to be going towards the bomb site. Adren holding a bit of an off angle here. Oh, Liko. Liquid Hiko. There we go. Liko. We've got Molotovs here. I would love to see one behind this box. And one under the there, right there as well. See a bit of spray coming in. Hiko gets 2 frags, far more than he should in that situation. That is crazy. And it's not even Stanislaw's kills. He's still got 2 HP, so it's looking good for Liquid here. 20 seconds left and Optic are running away. They don't have time to plant the bomb at A.
I think they might. It's going to be close. They need 3.5 seconds to plant. 3.5 seconds to plant. I think they got this. I mean, they just have to run and plant straight away, but they can do it. Look at that.
Are you serious?
He has 0.5 seconds left, James. It was planned all along. 0.5 seconds to spare.
That is...
It's a lifetime.
That is absurd.
And if you look at how this is going to change the dynamic, because now Stanislaw can defensively use the AWP, so there's actually a really, really big deal. Positioning is sick here. Well, potentially can be very sick from the Optic side.
He's getting greedy.
Oh, the baits. Forcing Nitro into the wide peak there to try to follow up there. And the smoke is... It's failed somewhat, but it will cover the approach at least. Adren looking for the 1v1. But, he's going to find it immediately. That's unfortunate there. All Naf had to do was try to delay time, but it looks like the bomb
is going to die.
Too ticked, because Adren does not have a kit either. And Optic, I have to say, Optic are exciting me a little bit here because they seem to be reinvigorated.
Oh my god, 2-1 there.
Wow.
He lost half his life there.
That's crazy. Oh my god, that's so close. I wonder how many units the difference would have, like, I wonder how many units away he was from dying there. That was ridiculous. And the fact that Optic are, you know, bolstered by the addition of Mixwell, this is kind of exciting because they've been playing some decent CS as well.
Upgrade of the year for North American team.
Yeah, to some extent, it reminds me a little bit of NIP with Threat, but I'll go back into that in a bit and why I think that. Optic now, Rush picking up the first frag. Oh my goodness, he's like shooting ducks. He's shooting ducks right now. He's at the shooting range.
He's in Dakota, Dan.
And all the ducks.
I think it's South Dakota where you can shoot ducks.
I don't know, James, because I've never.
No, it's North Dakota.
Thought about shooting
ducks.
I think
it's North Dakota, Dan.
But ducks have been shot. Ducks are innocent, James.
I have a friend who he runs the Sherdog radio station, MMA radio station, and he goes shooting, I think, in North Dakota. But back to the match. Liquid with three players remaining here. They've got no frags on the optic side just yet. Nitro failing over towards the A site, and you do not fancy their chances. Kusta and Elige, the last two men standing for Liquid. 40 horsey horse in the first map of this best of three. Coming in, desperate times for the Liquid side. See what they can do.
Well, so far, one versus five for Kusta. I don't know about this. He's going to get tagged down. He is dead. And 16-9, to me, that is a shocking but glorious result there for Optic, winning map one. And to quickly elaborate on the comparison I drew with NIP and Threats Edition, what Threats Edition was able to do for NIP, and you know what he did for NIP was creating all that structure and so on for the team. But what the effect that it had on the mentality of the players was it brought them all together, and another word for unity I was looking for, but it gave them a sense of unity essentially.
Unison?
I'll figure it out later. Getting a sense of unity, they started playing as a team, and they started believing in the team, and that belief became clear in their discipline. That's what allows them to be so disciplined. It's not just, you know, the threat holding them accountable. It's because they actually believe in what they're doing, and to some extent, I saw glimpses of that here from this Optic side. I could see the motivation there, and it's really cool to see how far they'll go. I don't want to be hyperbolic. I don't want to overblow it too much, but it's gonna be cool to see.